three hotels and sunshine year-round. The Miami-Dade Fire Rescue Department responded to nearly 176,000 calls last year.
There is an adrenaline rush with this job that's just incredible. We have a lot of domestic violence, stabbings and shootings, a large mixture of calls in this territory. It's a big territory.
Arrives at the scene in less than 10 minutes and finds a dangerous apartment fire in progress.
The hydrant's right at the entrance to the complex.
Hey, go ahead and let's go ahead and lay a line to
them. Firefighters don't know if anyone's trapped inside the apartment. Firefighters are ready to attack what they have come to know as the Red Devil. Firefighters must work quickly, as this fire could easily spread to other apartments. Without ventilation, the heat level will become unbearable, leaving no chance for a potential victim's survival. Still don't know if anyone's trapped inside.
Hey, Cliff! Was the place empty? No people? Man, it's hot. I'm thirsty. Steve, where you at? Is that you?
I need a pump. You got one right there. What do you want me to do?
Me?
I'm born ready.
Into the call and unable to gain roof access, the firefighters' only choice is to smash the front windows for initial ventilation. Because of the building's location, it's impossible to get the ladder truck near it, so firefighters won't be able to cut the other crucial roof ventilation hole. Ventilation will have to come from a different location.
Go around and brace the rear window. Can we reach them from up here?
Timing is critical, as the fire could soon get out of control.
Can you bring
truck access, firefighters resort to traditional ladders to gain quicker access to the back of the apartment. The fire must be contained. If it spreads next door, firefighters will have a major problem on their hands. The roof. 17 minutes after the call, and still no confirmation of victims. Firefighters must be extremely careful. They have limited oxygen supplies, and a combination of blinding smoke and temperatures rising upward of 1,200 degrees is deadly. Firefighters have discovered that the flames have now moved inside the apartment walls. This new development is called extension, and it is highly dangerous because it means this unseen fire could be traveling inside floors, walls, and ceiling spaces.
It's not in there. In it. It's not in there. Hold on. The ceiling. I just cut it down. It wasn't down before. We need a potato rake
is a standard wooden rake with metal prongs. Firefighters use them to move burning or hot materials.
Potato rake's coming. It'll be here in a minute.
Firefighters must rip apart most of the interior of the building to control fire extension. Because furniture can catch fire any moment, firefighters need to spray it down. Less than 30 minutes after the call, firefighters have successfully extinguished the fire. It has been confirmed that there were no victims inside.
Coming up to do overhaul.
I gotta grab my bottle of wine.
crew that's going to come up and do the overhaul.
All right, we got 38.
Okay.
My crew had run out of air after doing fire search, so we requested another crew to come up and do overhaul, which is basically to go ahead and pull all the garbage on the floor that falls from the roof and make sure that there's no fire that's extended underneath it. They're going to come in and pull the rest of the ceiling that we weren't able to get, and they're basically the relief crew at this time.
Is it okay to start the fan for this apartment?
Yes. Go ahead and start the fan. All the ceilings have been pulled everywhere. They put spot fires out on the floor. It's clear to go ahead and fire it up.
The fan helps to get rid of excess smoke and creates more ventilation. After the initial call, the overhaul crew enters the apartment for a final inspection.
The crew is going up on an attic ladder right now. They're just going up inside this ceiling. We have what is called vaulted ceiling, so they're like 12 feet high at the top. And they're just going to go up there and do a final check and make sure if there's anything else that we're going to miss. Started in the bathroom right behind me and extended out into the closet here, and then it extended into the closet and then it went out into the bedroom, got up into the roof. So the guys in here, what they're doing now is they're pulling all the insulation out. And by pulling out all the insulation, it's going to get all the trapped smoke, all this little bit of smoke that we keep seeing left up in there, and we'll get the rest of it out. We'll find out who lives in the apartment, the ages of them, what they need. We can get them food, shelter, transportation. We'll contact the Red Cross and we can get assistance for them. Rehab is where they send us after a fire, if it's a working code 1 fire, and the rescue guys will take our blood pressure and make sure it's okay for us to rehydrate us with this water.
That was my first fire.
We call you rookie, look the same. Good job. I got 260 over 180.
I try my best.
What is it? 260 over 180.
Yeah, a little high.
Want to go first act right?
Nah, I'm good. Just got a little hot.
Should be pretty interesting.
I love trauma.
Trauma, I mean, that's like the best. Property can be replaced. People cannot. Trauma is like first priority. That's what you train for, trauma.
Rescue workers arrive at the scene exactly 4 minutes after the call.
Let's see what's happening here.
Alarm 200.
She's got a stab wound to the upper right abdomen. It's in a very bad place. Could be some internal bleeding possibly.
Amazingly, the victim was able to place the call to 911 by herself. Her attacker is not yet identified. A rescue helicopter is called due to the severity of the stab wounds.
Scene of a 27 Delta 1 rep in the person stabbed in the stomach, 2870 Northwest 160.
Are you on the stay with them? I'll go with the captain to help set up the
LZ.
Firefighters must establish an LZ or landing zone in a nearby school field to assure a safe landing.
The LZ is going to be at 167th Street and 28th.
We have a trauma alert. What we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and set up an LZ so one of the air rescue units will come down and pick the patient up and transport her to Jackson Memorial Hospital. Okay. So we're going to go over to the LZ right now.
That's located in the battery area liver.
The major concern was internal bleeding with that kind of stab wound.
Rescue units carry their own set of keys to all public gates, so access is never a problem. Last year in Miami, over 1,500 helicopter rescue missions were recorded. Conscious, but remains in critical condition. Without the helicopter, it could take as long as 30 minutes to get the victim to the hospital. The helicopter will get her there in less than 10. That timing can mean the difference between life and death.
On arrival, they had a status right at the quadrant of the patients. We take vitals. We measure the O2 saturation, their blood pressure, and we monitor their heart. Her veins weren't very good, so we weren't able to get an ID. Rushing, the mind's going mile a minute, and you have very little time to do what we have to do.
Again, timing is critical. If the blood vessels behind the liver had been punctured, the victim could possibly bleed to death.
I've always wanted to be involved with the good calls, the most exciting calls. We have the minimal amount of time to do the most for the patient. If we can make a difference and to get in there in that short period of time, especially with trauma, because it's really critical.
Thank you. Bravest wishes to support the families of the heroic firefighters who lost their lives during the World Trade Center tragedy.